What's up, everybody? Hey, today I'm here to talk to you about the Auto DIY lever. Now, it's not a full lever, it's an upgrade kit for the San Juan JLF, but because of the number of parts that we have to exchange out, I'm gonna call it the Auto DIY lever in this video, and we'll just go with that. Now, there are two versions of this kit, and you can see them over here. They're kind of laid out, not all in the, each kit, if you will, but laid out as, so I can show you guys everything. This lever here that I'm showing right now, this is actually built out with the Auto V2 kit. And the V2 kit is actually the more interesting, in my opinion, of the two, because it really changes the feel of the JLF completely. It uses this silicon grommet as the pivot instead of the more traditional bowl and half bowl design, if you will, on the pivot like the standard JLF uses. It comes with a bunch of pieces and parts, and later in the video I'm going to actually go ahead and show you everything that comes in the kits and how to assemble it in your JLF. But before we get into that, I just want to talk about everything at first, just to kind of lay everything out and explain what this kit actually is. So the kit actually comes with two of these gates. One is the FD, the Foxtrot Delta gate, and that's the traditional square gate. That's what we're used to in the JLF that comes stock. And then this one I actually have in my hand. This is the BYF, the Bravo Yankee Foxtrot gate. And this is actually a modified FD gate. It takes a circle gate and the square gate kind of combines the two and creates a hybrid gate. So you can still fill the corners, but do a 360 degree rotation very easily without getting tripped up in the corners. So that comes with a kit. Both of those gates come with a kit. And one thing you'll notice is that these are one piece designs here, meaning you don't take this part out in the middle like you do with a standard JLF gate and replace it with a new geometry. It's a one piece design. Now that actually has a lot of benefits because it takes out some of the slop and some of the wear parts and the rubbing between the two pieces that could happen over time, and the unibody construction or the unipart construction, if you will, it's a more robust build, if you will, which is great. You don't want any slop in your gate, so that removes all of that by making it a single piece. Now, this is actually made out of nylon, not ABS plastic like you're used to, or acrylic, so this is not going to eat into any of your actuators, and it's going to have a lot of resiliency because nylon doesn't get as brittle as plastic over time. Now, if we move over to the pivots, these are actually machined out of Teflon. Teflon is a great material. It's got high durability and low friction, meaning this is going to last a lot longer than the standard pivot that the JLF has, because the JLF's made out of, I think, maybe Delrin and ABS plastic. I'm not 100% sure, so if that's not right, please leave a comment down below and correct me, but they're definitely not made out of Teflon. These are made out of Teflon, so the amount of grease that you're going to need to use is significantly less, which is great, and it's just going to last a lot longer, because that's just the properties of Teflon. They're really good properties, so that's awesome. Then it comes with the three actuators. I've actually got one installed into the lever already. I use the 12mm actuator here, but you also get a 12.5mm, and a 13mm actuator that comes in the kit as well. So you can really reduce the dead zone, if you will, between the actuator and the switches by having these oversized actuators. And you can always use your stock actuator if you don't want to oversize as well. So that's kind of nice. If you look closer here at the body of the lever, this is actually included with the kit. This is also made out of nylon. You replace the stock JLF body with this nylon one. It fits the standard TPMA switchboard, as well as you can upgrade with standalone switches like these. These are some Panasonic ones I picked up. I'd have to trim these lever arms here to make it work, but you can use that as well. Or any of the Cherry switches and stuff that are available and a lot of people mod their JLFs with as well, all fit fine in this body. So my first impressions of this has been very good. If they weren't good, I wouldn't want to carry them in my store. corresponding with Otto has been fantastic. He's always looking at ways to improve it and add parts and functionality. So I like that. That means these are going to be supported for a long time, and we may see some iterations and some improvements, maybe some new gates over the course of the next couple months. I'm going to keep pushing for that because I think there's some room for different things like octo gates and perfect circle gates as well, and maybe even some oversized yet smaller actuators, maybe in the 11 millimeter and 11.5 millimeter range. All right, so let's talk about what comes in the kits. First, we're going to talk about the V2. I call it the Korean JLF hybrid lever when it's all said and done, because you've got the benefits of the silicon grommets with the standard form factor and tension provided by the spring of the JLF. So it's not a pure JLF and it's not a pure Korean stick. It just kind of mashes some of the benefits of both of them together into one nice package. So that's why I call it that. It's going to come with the body, the four screws and nuts that hold the body to the stock JLF plate, two gates, both the FD and the BYF, the three oversized actuators in 12, 12 and a half, and 13 millimeters, and then it comes with the pivot housing here, as well as two silicon rings for different tensions. One's a 40 and one's a 60 weight. The 40 is less, the 60 is more. You can feel it when you press on them. One has a little bit more elasticity than the other, meaning it's easier to bend and pop back to normal than the other. And it's also gonna come with this Shinetsu grease that we put together. It's just a little dab, that's all you're gonna need. You don't need a lot of grease with these kits, and this fancy, very fancy 2 millimeter Allen key. So you're going to get that in the kit. You'll take your standard JLF apart and then retrofit all these pieces in, and you'll be good to go. One thing I didn't mention is it comes with a spring. It's a slightly less taut spring than the stock JLF one. You can use the stock JLF one as well as either of the grommets and kind of mix and match to get your tension just right in this lever. Which it just provides a lot of flexibility, and that is really cool. Now, if we kind of set the silicon rings aside, let's look at the V5, which is the silky smooth JLF lever when it's all said and done. It's gonna come with the same things, pretty much. It's gonna come with the Shinetsu grease, the Allen key, the three oversized actuators, both gates, and the body. However, it's not gonna come with a spring, and it's gonna come with this pivot here, which is the ball and socket style pivot that you're used to in the JLF. This is, again, made out of machined Teflon. All of the pivots are made out of machined Teflon, so you're gonna enjoy the awesome durability associated with that, as well as the silky smooth, low coefficient of friction associated with Teflon, meaning you're gonna have a great experience. This thing's gonna move really easily and smoothly inside the pivot at all times. And you're really gonna cut down on the maintenance you have to do to keep this thing clean and functioning, because you just use a lot less grease. So we're gonna go ahead and talk pros and cons. This will fit the JLF. I haven't tried it on a Hayabusa plate to see if this all lines up, but I can't see any reason it wouldn't, as long as these holes here line up. It is compatible with the stock shaft. Anything that has the common bottom of the JLF should fit fine. I'll show you guys that the Freakmods link works fine. We've got a little bit of coverage of that in the install how-to that's coming up. And it's going to be compatible with any of the oversized actuators and the higher tension springs available from a lot of different part shops. Now, Otto does recommend you don't go above a 2 pound spring with the V2 kit. He says it'll wear down the silicon grommets too fast because there's just too much tension forces between the two. It'll work fine for a little while, but he does caution to not go above 2 pounds with that kit. So beyond that, there's a lot of other information out there. You can use this kit with the Kwamba levers that are not Sanwa. And if you want to actually modify it even more and get rid of the TPMA PCB that comes with the JLF that you reuse, this is a fine example of a switch you can put in there in the body and use in its place. These are these are Omron switches with little arm levers here that are not trimmed yet. But you can use those, or you can use the silent cherry switches or even the regular cherry switches in place of this TPMA and get a different feel altogether there as well. So there's really a lot of options. Now, the cool thing about this kit is it's not just a spring upgrade. It's not just an actuator upgrade. Those are basic mods that have been available for the JLF for a long time. It kind of takes a lot of different things and combines them into the mod. You're replacing the body, you're replacing the gate, you're replacing the actuator, you're replacing the pivots, and you're just doing a lot of mods to it all at one time. And the new pivots and the new gates, as well as the materials are made out of, it's all new. No one's done this before, and it provides a really cool, complete modding situation, and I love it. So this one right here is actually gonna go into my Namor fight stick, my Panzer fight stick that I use all the time, because I actually really enjoy the added tension that Korean levers bring, but I also like the springy factor that you get with a JLF. It's weird, I know. So this is a kind of a great stick for me, and that's the one I'm going to be using. If you're more familiar with the JLF and you really like the JLF feel, then obviously the V5 kit's probably going to be more suited for you. So let's go ahead and take this all apart, put it all back together, and show you how it all goes together, and yeah, we're good to go. Okay, now that we've walked through the install of these, it's up to you to decide whether this kit is for you. There's a lot that I can't convey over a video on feel of these parts. It's just not possible. What feels good to me is not gonna feel good to you, and what may work for me is not gonna work for you. And that's why there are 100 different layouts for fight sticks. That's why people use Hitbox. That's why people use Korean levers only. And that's why some people have a preference over Sumitsu and Sanwa. In my opinion, this kit is going to give you a great opportunity to try some new things that haven't been tried before. The JLF hybrid is awesome. That Korean tension that you feel with the silicon grommets is a new, unique feel that a lot of people haven't tried, or a lot of people haven't experienced unless they use Fantas or Crown levers. And then that silky smooth V5 with that all Teflon pivot is just, oh, it's so buttery smooth. It just feels so good when it's installed. But once you guys get it and you try it for yourself, please shoot me a message down in the comments below so that I can get a better feel of what you think of this kit, because I already know I like it, and I think you will too, but there's some things about it you're gonna like that maybe I didn't like. You're gonna find some things that you liked about it I didn't even think of, and that all just kind of helps the community decide whether this upgrade kit or the V2 upgrade kit is right for them. If you liked this video, hit that thumbs up button. If not, well, too bad. I guess you can hit that thumbs down button though. Make sure you hit that bell icon to be notified when I post something new, and while you're over there, click the subscribe button. It actually does help me out. If you are a social media sort of person, check me out at Jason's Customs on Twitter or facebook.com/Jason's Customs. And last but certainly not least, check out my website, www.jasonscustoms.com, for some sweet, sweet fight stick and arcade gear. Until next time, this is Jason, and I'll catch you guys later. Peace.